The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh, my enemies and my foes, they stumbled and fell. Though an army may encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war may rise against me, in this I will be confident. Life will come at you with the most severe punches and brutal blows. And for the most years of my life, it has. Receiving the news about my dad's passing over the phone 2 weeks after his death, and after not seeing him for 5 years since I last left Ghana, and then losing my granddad a week later. You can then imagine the pain my mother has been through, losing a father as well as a husband. Life will lock you down if you let it. For it's not about the number of times you get hit, but it hits you and endure as you keep moving forward. Like Jonah in the belly of a whale. My fight as an immigrant began with the belief my parents had in me before I ever had one in myself. The youngest of my family, Joseph. I was sent to the land of Egypt, a land unknown to me, to face trials and tribulations on behalf of my parents, on behalf of my brothers, that one day they will come and enjoy the fruits of my labor, provided by my heavenly Father. Alone in the field, walking through the valley of the shadow of death, I feared no evil, for he was with me every step of the way. He equipped me with a rod and a staff, and blessed me with the insight of understanding what my purpose was. Through the gift of my creativity, I found myself through him, and this became my importance. To use the gift I have been blessed with to create a path, not only for myself and my family, but for others as well, that his purpose in my life may be fulfilled. Being directed by the Holy One, I set on this journey of faith, using my talent as my power and prayer as my weapon, breaking down doors and casting down demons. He led me to my destiny helpers and allowed his favor to open doors before me and cause my gift to bring me before kings, working and collaborating with people I never imagined. That boy from the land of Canaan was doing wonders in Egypt, raising the bar and lifting the last name of my father up in the clouds. All I wanted to do was make my family proud. It was happening. Every day I worked hard in the field, picking cotton for long hours and breaking my back in the sun, spending bags on bags for the renewal of my papers. I contributed to the growth of the arts and the music industry to keep the banner of my family name afloat. But like every story, there was always a dream killer. My visa had almost reached its expiration, and letters came flying through from the keepers of the field, whispering violently, "You got 14 days to leave the country." Was this my ending? My walls began to cave in. I hid myself in the rocks and stayed in, frozen with fear, covered in rubble and dust. I thought to myself, what better way to return them? For in dust I was made. Suicidal thoughts running laps through my mind. I was out of breath, ready to throw in the towel. No. Louder. For I knew he that began a good work in me will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. With my back against the ropes, he kept my mind right and my enemies left. Left hook, right hook, I kept jabbing and moving with the holy book. For my life was worth nothing to me unless I used it for finishing the work assigned to me by the Lord. For my gift is my ministry, and he has assured me that his grace was sufficient for me, that I could do all things. Not some things, but all things, through Christ who strengthened me. For the Lord was my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord has been the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Through it all, he was with me, and he never left my side. For the victory was mine, and the battle was his. My name is Koby Martin, and this is my story as an immigrant.